Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato. On today's Everything Music, we're going to count down the top 10 rock songs on Spotify. Now, I've done the top 10 pop songs, a couple of videos of those, but honestly, I haven't really listened to what the rock songs are. Now, there's a playlist on Spotify called Rock This and see what's really happening in rock music in 2021. Let's check it out. Coming in at number 10 is a song by Weezer. The song's called All My Favorite Songs. Let's check it out. Sounds like a mellotron. Okay. I've not heard this.
Favorite songs are slow and sad.
Interesting modulation there, right?
All my favorite people make me mad. Everything that feels so good is bad, bad, bad.
So it's one, major three, six, four. Kind of a lo-fi drum sound.
Cause I need a friend when I take a walk. I like spacing out when somebody talks.
Interesting. You know, for me, that kind of chord progression there is kind of like Radiohead creep. Although they would actually go to the four chord then four minor. But that one, two, major three is a very classic chord progression there, and it's nice to hear something that's not totally diatonic. Diatonic means all in the same key. Okay, so that's cool. Let's move to the next one. Song number 9 is called Estella. It's by Kenny Hoopla featuring Travis Barker, the former drummer of Blink-182. Actually, the first What Makes This Song Great that I did was All the Small Things by Blink-182, who I love. They're one of my favorite bands of that era. Let's check this out. This is probably a pop punk song. Now, one thing about this that's interesting, I can tell just right there on this fill. Listen to this. That's actually real playing. I can tell on the drums. That's not been quantized. That's actually real drumming. It gets major points for me just for that, for having the drums not being gridded, meaning quantized or fixed. I really like that. But I'm a real sucker for pop punk, so maybe I'm not the most unbiased person when it comes to that. Song number 8 is called Mercy by Aaron James. Let's check it out. Okay, the low string I can tell is tuned way down. B flat down the octave. Guitars are doing a line cliche. Cool lick. I like kick drum and bass together. I like that. Kind of a bluesy line.
Dead grip on my soul. Chains won't let me go.
That's cool.
A lot of reverb on the vocals. I dig that line cliche, the chord progression in the verse. Very cool. I like the do-do-do-do-do-do-do riff in the chorus. I want to listen to that one some more times. Song number 7 is Every Time You Leave featuring Delaney Jane. This is I Prevail. Let's check it out. Beautiful sounds, beautiful pads. Okay, so that's something unusual. The chorus actually starts on the last chord of the verse, which is A. Listen. Right here. Cool. Holds on E. Now, in comparison to everything we've heard, this song is way louder. It's way more compressed. It sounds huge. I mean, it's very much a very higher production level, more produced sounding. Beautiful. Sounds great. Song number 6 is called Dirty by Grandson. Let's check it out.
Is it time to lead or is it time to die? Time to
really thin bass sound. Cool.
Is there anybody out there that's playing its sunshine? Yeah. Is it time to speak?
I like these kind of like old school vibes like that.
Is it time to lead or is it time to die? Time to raise hello, walk on by. Is there anybody out there that's playing its sunshine?
Yeah, that's cool.
Is it time to speak up or time for silence?
Down to F that time, okay, it's different. Love the distorted vocals. Really distorted vocals in the chorus and the breaks. Double vocal. You hear the electronic music part of that in there, right? It's definitely influenced by contemporary music, but it also has that retro vibe, something that you would have heard from maybe the Killers 20 years ago now. But really distorted voice, very rock and roll. It's a cool song. Song number 5 is called Flames featuring Avril Lavigne, and it's by Mod Sun. Let's check it out.
I still burn for you.
Keyboards, right?
I still burn for you. I still burn
okay.
For you.
Let's tune down a half step.
I still burn.
I think, great singing. So this is a kind of rock song, rap song.
I still burn for
Obviously, this has a lot of pop overtones, but it has all these different elements blended together, kind of like Post Malone. High production value compared to some of the other ones. It's interesting. If you go from the Weezer at 10, has a almost indie sound to it, and this one is very pop-influenced, rap, dance music. It's got all these different things. There's a rock element to it, but really the rock element to me comes from the singing. Song number 4 is called Typhoons by Royal Blood. Let's check it out. Cool sound. C sharp. Tune down to low D flat. Sus thing. That's cool. Nice. That's great rhythm. Okay, I don't know. I can't really play this because I'm not tuned. Okay, so say it. That's it. Listen. Great, great lick. Oh, nice. Wow. Nice, fresh. Okay, the guitar parts are cool. The vocals are cool. The drums sound really very good. Really? And the riff is amazing. Great singing too. Wow. Really dig that one. Song number 3 is Waiting on a War by Foo Fighters. I've been waiting on a war since I was young. Since I was a little boy with a toy gun. I love this A7 sus 4. Beautiful. Just wanted to love everyone. Is it more than this than that? Is it more than this than that? Is it more than this than that? Is it more than this? See? Okay, so the chorus, D, B flat, F, C, D, B flat, F, G. Let's listen to it again. Refreshing when you hear a modulation like that. We rarely hear these things. I've been doing these Spotify top 10 countdowns. I've done 2 pop song ones. I've done the rock ones now. And this is one of the first times that I've heard an actual modulation right there, right? It's just so fresh sounding. It's like, why don't people do that more often? Well, because they're not Dave Grohl. Coming in at number two is Only Love Can Save Me Now, featuring Matt Cameron and Kim Thayil. For those of you that know Soundgarden, that is the drummer and guitar player. They both have unmistakable styles. This is the Pretty Reckless with Taylor Momsen singing. Taylor is awesome. Let's check it out. Well, that's Kim Thayil's wah-wah. I know that anywhere. I mean, seven, four. Whoa! Okay, that's amazing. Already it sounds huge. The drums are phenomenal. The guitar is really massive. 7-4 riff. We've had no songs in Odd Time Signatures in any of these videos I've done on the Spotify Top 10. None in the pop, obviously. And none in the rock yet, right? So let's check it out. Let me play this riff here. Drums, you hear ghost notes in the hi-hat, you hear grace notes in the snare. Come on, you got Odd Time Signature already. What's that kick drum matter? I like it. Bar of five right there. Let's check this out here. Right here. So this is why we got into playing guitar. That's why I got into it, is to play great riffs like that. I mean, that is incredible. And I even had the SG to play it like Kim Thayil. So cool. Coming in at number one, once again, The Pretty Reckless and So It Went, featuring Tom Morello. I guess Tom Morello plays a guitar solo on this. This is Taylor Momsen again. Let's check it out. Cool sound. Okay, this is in 7 right here, this section. Such a waste of time. up a step, and back to four. Incredible singing. Taylor's a great singer. Nice. Nice.
Belong to you, it don't belong to you. It belongs to me.
Awesome. Wow, that's cool. Let me hear Tom Morello.
Okay,
here we go. Nice. Wow, killer. So there you have the top 10 rock songs on the Rock This Spotify playlist. It's really interesting for me since I haven't listened to a lot of rock music over the last, I don't know, 5 years or so since I stopped producing. And interesting to see what types of elements have been drawn into rock music now. But it's great to hear kind of old school rock songs too that there are in here. Love to know your thoughts. Leave them in the comments. That's all for now. Don't forget to subscribe. If you're a first time viewer, ring the bell. That'll let you know when I go live and when a new video comes out. Give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment. That's very important. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. Follow me on Instagram at rickbeato1. Check out the new Beato ear training program at BeatoEarTraining.com. And if you want to support the channel even more, think about becoming a member of the Beato Club. Thanks for watching.